From the Watergate building in Washington, this is Hotline TV. Now, here are Hotline editors Chuck Todd and John Mercurio.
It's the day after the day after, and we're recapping the Florida primary. Hi, everyone. I'm John Mercurio.
Hello, recappers.
And I'm Chuck Todd. Welcome to Hotline TV, Tuesday's Florida primaries. Didn't offer many surprises, but they did do something to clarify the national landscape. At least one Democratic senator is getting reelected, isn't he, Mr. Mercurio?
He is indeed the luckiest senator in the U.S. Senate.
There's Bill a whole Nelson. Caucus like that. I think Barbara Boxer has been the chairman of that caucus for years. Patty Murray is the co-chair.
Right.
Some people like, I can't believe they're 2- and 3-term and 4-term senators.
Right. Caucus. And Bill Nelson joins that firm. Because not only is he going to be reelected, but he's got $14 or $16 trillion in his bank account.
Which he will hoard and hog and not give a dime to Jim Davis, who really needs it in that governor's race.
Right, exactly. The governor's race is also set. It'll be Democratic Congressman Jim Davis against Republican Attorney General Charlie Crist, just as we predicted, Mr. Todd, yes?
I think so. I think we both nailed that. It's pretty easy. Crist, at this point, we can call this race now. It's Governor Crist. He's going to be the governor.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think you're right at this point.
It's not fair to Davis. I agree. It's not fair to Davis, but they're not going to have the money. The National Party's not sending the money. The DGA's not going to send money, supposedly. It would be shocking. And unless Bill Nelson puts up some money, and he's got plenty of it to do, if he cares about the Florida Democratic Party, he will get involved. Mm-hmm. If he only cares about Bill Nelson's long-term career,
right. He
won't. And I have a feeling they're going to have... We'll see. The DSCC, by the way, is counting on a big Bill Nelson contribution because
right.
they claim, hey, you know, we helped talk this up and helped you make sure you kept Catherine Harris in. Now give us a little payback.
Well, I mean, I think Bill Nelson, more than anybody, owes his fundraising success to Catherine Harris.
So he ought to give a couple of bucks back to somebody.
But I think it's ironic that on a national level, whereas President Bush is driving down Republican fortunes, I think Charlie Crist owes his victory at the end, if he wins by a large margin, to the fact that he's the Republican successor to Jeb Bush, who is the most popular governor right now.
As hundreds of viewers know.
He's the most popular governor in Florida.
As the hundreds of viewers here know. I was in Florida, was in Miami Labor Day for it.
Correct.
And there was some football thing going on, but I don't want to talk about that. However, you turn on the television, and it was, you thought Jeb Bush was running for something.
Right.
He appeared in every single ad, whether it was somebody running for state senate, the CFO, Jeb Bush, it was like Jeb Bush, Jeb Bush, Jeb Bush. Of course, it was Jeb, emphasis on the Jeb Bush, you know,
right.
really quiet, but still, it's just... Stunning.
He's more popular. He's almost as popular with Democrats as his brother is with Republicans. I mean, with the overall country.
It does seem that way. By the way, you know, Florida's going to be one state. Democratic turnout statewide was horrid.
Down.
One of the lowest.
It was raining in
ever.
South Florida.
Sure.
Raining
but
hard.
It was down 37% compared to 2002, and they didn't spend much money in that
right.
race. Yes, everybody knew who Jan Arena was. That's not a good thing if, say, you're Ron Klein running against Clay Shaw and you're counting on an enthusiastic Democratic turnout in
you've
South Florida.
Already, see, you've gotten ahead of me. That's one of my bandwagons that I'm jumping off of. We'll get to that.
We'll get to that someday.
All right. Someday.
Hey, that's going to do it for today's Hotline TV. Tune in tomorrow for a preview of the September 12th primaries, a look at underreported governor's races and a few bandwagons. We're jumping off. Until then, I'm Chuck Todd.
You jumping off my bandwagon?
I've been off your bandwagon for years.
I'm John Mercurio. We'll catch you tomorrow on Hotline Television.